Thank you, EA, for sponsoring this video. Hey, it's Ocean Sims, and as you all know, February is dedicated to Black history. For this year's Black History Month theme, The Sims will be focusing on the Black family, representation, identity, and diversity. Black culture is so incredibly broad and diverse that it's nearly impossible to capture the essence of it and everyone's individual stories in its entirety in this one video. So I want to take you all on a virtual field trip with a beautiful Black family that I created. This family is actually based loosely off of my own personal experiences, how I was raised, and what I've learned thus far. Meet the Wrights. They're a family of four who live in the quiet neighborhood of Newcrest with their two children, Jaycion and Charlene. Rhonda and Jamal have actually been together since graduating high school and have literally been together ever since. Jamal works as a professor at Wrightchester University, and Rhonda is a social justice worker for No Sim Left Behind. When Rhonda isn't protesting, she earns simoleons by selling her homemade candles on Plopsy. She's thinking of like making a store, maybe calling it Candles by Rhonda. Maybe she'll own a store one day, maybe when the kids get older. You know, their kids keep them pretty busy. And Jaycion, the oldest, has big dreams of going to Foxbury University. As badly as his dad wants him to go to Wrightchester, Jaycion knows that his future belongs at Foxbury. See, he loves basketball, and in fact, he loves sports in general. But to be honest, he doesn't want his athletics to define him. Jaycion actually wants to go to school for computer programming and hopefully become an engineer one day. And if he does, he'd be the first engineer in his family, and he does not take that lightly. And then there's Charlene. She's a musical genius with a love for the violin. Her passion is classical and jazz music. Did you know that the most important influence on 20th century music were from African Americans? Yes, this little girl has big plans on becoming a musical genius and always being herself while she climbs her way to the top. So this is the Wright family, and I absolutely love them. They will actually be on the gallery so that you can play out their story however you wish. And I forgot to mention there is a grandmother who is in this household as well, and her name is Mabel Wright. She actually lives in Willow Creek, so she lives about a neighborhood or two away, but she plays a humongous role in their family. And I will show you why, because I want to show you guys how the Wrights live their life. I want to show you what being Black means to me based on my own personal experiences. And I want to show you guys how, you know, their tradition, what they do as a family. So without further ado, let's just jump right in game. All right, so we are in game, and as you guys can see, the Wrights live in this beautiful home made by Lil Simsy on the gallery, and I just kind of made it look more like the Wrights, you know, how they would decorate their home. But right now it's 5:03 in the evening, and I don't know about your parents, but my parents are like huge movie buffs. Like, my dad would always come home with some DVDs, and I'm like, you know, Dad, like, where'd you get this? We had like so many movies. I don't even know where half of them came from, but it was like my dad always had a new movie to watch, so we popped some popcorn, and then we'd like, you know, we'd be chilling in our little jammies or whatever the case may be, and we'd have some like one-on-one family time. I find this as a way for everyone to just like spend time with each other, and you know, it's a way to just kind of like wind down. So I'm actually gonna have Jamal here just sit. He'll probably sit. We even have Grandma Mabel here. She is actually here. She chills with him sometimes for movie nights. And then of course we're gonna have Charlene choose the movie. It's her night to choose the movie, and I think she's gonna want to watch something sad, so she's gonna watch Lost Dog's Journey Home with the whole fam bam. I can smell the popcorn already. We're all gonna grab a serving before we watch this movie. Everyone's getting ready to watch the movie. I love this. Movie nights are like a way to just kind of like wind down with your family, kind of talk without talking, and that was just like always a vibe in my house for some reason. It's like, yeah, now this is a reason for everyone to be quiet and just enjoy the movie. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, so one thing is that a lot of the times the Wrights don't like watching movies with Jamal because he either ruins the movie's plot or talks too much while in the movie. And it is not movie night if you don't turn off all the lights, right? You gotta make it kind of quiet. I just love that we can do this in The Sims 4, you know, turn off the lights and just like really set that whole ambiance. The movie is done. Of course, Jamal has everything to say about it. He's going to complain about the actors. He's going to ask questions about the movie plot. I love these interactions. He has so much to say about the movies, and that was kind of like my dad. It's like my dad has so much to say about the plots in the movies, what he thought and why he thought like certain things were happening. Maybe it's a dad thing, but I just remember it so clearly. He's like, I wish the dog would have found it its way home at the very end of the movie, you know, and not have suspense. The acting was terrible. So growing up, I felt like there was always something to be learned. Like, I feel like I was always instilled with so many like life lessons. And, you know, here in the Wright family, Jamal knows the importance of a Black father and his role in the family. Since he's older, Jaceon tends to get the most lectures about, you know, his responsibilities, life, friends, family, education, everything under the sun. Like anything Jamal didn't know growing up, he passes on to Jaceon. And, you know, Jamal wants nothing more than for his son to defy stereotypes and feel empowered in this world. So there's a lot of lectures, a lot of, you know, personal talks. I feel like it's so important for parents to have discussions with kids that make them feel uncomfortable because it can prepare them for life outside of this world. And I am so grateful that I was raised in an environment like that, to have a parent that cared for me so much that they could tell me life's hardships, the good things, the bad, and even things that they've personally been through, so that, you know, it could prepare me for the life that I was going to live. So today actually calls this for a celebration because Jaceon just got awarded the esports scholarship, and he's super excited because at Foxbury, this is huge. He loves video games, he loves computers, and this is literally just huge. The Wrights live a simple life, but they're well known for throwing cookouts for like every little event. So we have here a holiday that I created, it's scholarship acceptance, which obviously if you have seasons, you can do this. We are going to have a cookout, okay? We basically have a cookout for everything. You know, someone just graduated, it's a holiday, you know, just got married, a job promotion, I don't know. Just, you better believe the Wrights are going to throw a cookout with their close family and friends to celebrate life's biggest and smallest achievements. So being that we're going to throw a cookout today, we're going to invite all of our family and friends, but first we are going, okay, this is how you know it's time to clean up, okay? We're going to play some music, we are going to blast it loud, and we are going to start cleaning up the house because we have company over, okay? So you know it's time to clean when you hear music playing. You can literally smell the cleaning products just fumigating through the house. You're like, yo, it's time to clean. So I'm gonna have mom in here. She's going to clean this. She's gonna say, hey, Jaceon, you know, I'm gonna throw a little something here. Let's just pretend that it was kind of planned, you know, at least a day in advance. And she wants everyone to kind of clean up, straighten up the house because we are going to invite our family and friends over. You know, it's about family and friends. It's about, you know, connecting with the people that we love. We even have Dad coming in here helping Jaceon clean and everything. He knows exactly how his wife likes the house. Look at him. He's all tense because of it. He's like, oh my gosh, I know it's cleaner in here, but oh my goodness. We definitely have to get the food cooking. So I'm going to have Jamal like out here on the grill. He is going to make some hamburgers. He has his disco music, his old school jams playing, and he has on what I like to call the grill sandals. Like, everybody had like an uncle or something that had on these sandals right here that you're looking at. Okay, that means he's a grill master. Okay, like y'all, this is like taking me back. You don't understand. He's like, what do you know about this music, Charlene? What do you know about this music? I'm also going to have Jamal make some hot dogs. Charlene is going to keep him company and talk his head off. And then we have to invite our friends over. I'm not going to throw an event. We're just going to casually invite our friends and family over. Everyone we know. It's just like, hey, if you're in town, if you're up the street or whatever the case may be, stop by and get a plate. We have some banana cream pie. We also have some bread pudding. She made some desserts. And then, you know, of course, Jamal threw down on the grill. So I'm super thankful for that. But she's going to go ahead and finish up here. And then I'll also have her like dress into, you know, something really nice for the weather and everything. So then, you know, they all just kind of like enjoy their time with each other, chit chat, you know, talk about how Jaceon got accepted, how he feels about it. And then, you know, the teens go ahead and do their own thing. But as you can see, you know, if you're just bird's eye view, you can tell that like you want to be a part of this family. You want to stop by, get a plate, and chit chat with them. It's just good vibes only here. So the kids love the weekends because almost every weekend they visit their grandma. Before they would visit their grandparents, but their grandfather passed away not too long ago, so they just kind of like kick back and relax with their grandma. If they're not going to service with her, then sometimes they even volunteer with her, which I'm gonna actually have them do. For some reason, it feels like whenever they go to their grandma's house, there is always something that they leave with, whether that's a lesson, whether that's a new skill, or whatever the case may be. One thing I'm gonna have them do is volunteer at a nursing home. You know, our grandma knows a lot of elderly, okay? And I just feel like it would be nice for her to say, hey y'all, like these are my grandkids that came here to help out. And so they're gonna go ahead and do that together for the weekend. It seems like every single time they come here to grandma's house that she always has something planned, you know? So after they get done with this, they're actually gonna come back, and I'm sure they're probably gonna go fishing or something of the sort. Look at them. See, volunteering is fun and builds character. It feels good to do things for others. And see, like I told y'all, there's always a lesson to be learned here. So the kids are back. And normally, you know, their grandma would like cook them a nice homemade meal of their choosing, whatever they wish, because they have big bellies and they, you know, she loves to feed her grandbabies sweets, bakery goods, whatever. Cooking runs deep in this family. Whenever the kids go to their grandma's, it almost feels like they're taken out of the normal element that they're in. And they are like so humbled when they are with her. And it just feels like a new dynamic, if you know what I mean. And it's just so cool because she's always telling them about old stories, you know, just with her life. And it just makes you appreciate the small things. I feel like there's so much to learn from the elderly and people that have lived here longer than us. And that's just kind of like the vibes that we get when we're here chilling with our Grandma Mabel. Being a part of a Black family means being confident, proud, and most importantly, unapologetic. Growing up in a world where you don't see yourself being represented in video games, magazines, TV shows can actually form a perception that is untrue. So I just want to remind you that Black is beautiful, and in Black families, it's important to remind the youth that they are noble, loved, and gifted. I grew up in a family that showed me what Black excellence was, you know, lawyers, nurses, Marines, to hardworking individuals like my dad, who works so incredibly hard for me and my family. So this way of thinking has nurtured my present day family, and I can take what my family taught me and pass it on to my three Black children. Thank you, Sims, for allowing me to share my story and experiences. Happy Black History Month. Don't forget to take the time to look into Black history and contributions today. Remember to just keep simming. Always, always, always stay wavy, and I will see y'all in the next video. Peace out.